shots in the west. We make believers out the best. Lay the weak to rest. In Southern California, I ain't no place like this. Have the stuff y'all doing, we created the shit. So don't be sagging, young buck, in the presence of this. Don't even come from the city and you running your lips.
Who's people in the state?
People in the stairs are Mike and Chris, two dummies who met in LA back in 94, 95, around that time. We had a common love for hip-hop, the Beatnuts, Gangstar, Freestyle Fellowship, NWA.
All the greats.
Freestyling, Whoppers, drinking giant, thin portions of soda, getting in trouble, yelling at people. So, you know, we came together like that, and then we both, we made beats. That was what it was. We were producers. We cared about music. He was the only guy I ever met who I could talk to about, you know, I love this hip-hop record, but have you heard this Roy Ayers record? And, you know, because the MCs that I knew, they last thing they wanted to do was sit around and listen to me do great vibes, you know. But, so we linked up and we had beats, and then I think we realized that we didn't want to give beats to other people.
So we just started writing ourselves and rapping over our own beats.
The show, or the time that people see us on tours, is 1 hour out of the day, 2 hours out of the day. But we spend the rest of the 24 hours pretty much in a car together doing other stuff and stuff. So there's been tons of experiences. He almost fell off the Great Wall in China. That was awesome.
Yeah, that's another dope experience. We almost died in China. That was crazy.
What happened there?
Well, I've never ridden what's that thing called, a ski lift before. And I, you know, coming down, getting back to Earth or whatever, I didn't know that I had to lift my legs up. Or I would fall and I almost fell 6,000 feet down the Great Wall.
Yeah. And I was a bad homie because I laughed.
Yeah, he was in front of me laughing, videotaping.
It was funny.
It was funny. You know, once I got down here,
there's not crying. Creepy music playing the whole time too, you know. And then there were these dudes dressed up like Mongolians waiting for me.
Scared the shit out of me.
It was dope because in Cape Town, the promoter, we had talked to the promoter, and we weren't really. It wasn't, the whole tour wasn't set up for us to make money. It was set up for us to go down there, to meet with the kids, to build with them. And so the ticket prices were really cheap. I think it was $5 or whatever the equivalent was to see our show. So because of that, when we got up on stage in Cape Town, it was like everyone had come and could afford to come see us. And we had heard that a lot of rappers would come down there and tickets would be $50 because they're like, I need to get paid. And we had it open, and the energy in that room was
crazy.
It smelled like armpit. There was beer flying everywhere. No.
I smoked weed out of carrots.
Seriously, it was wild.
I mean, me and this guy, on tour, we listen to excellent radio, trying to listen to the new hot rap, mainly just laughing at it. But we'll find ourselves, writing rhymes and start to sound like them. It's like, okay, we gotta stop listening to that shit. Yeah. You know? But not really
taking dramatic pauses between, when we came out, we weren't trying to sound like anyone around us in LA. And then there was a period of time where everyone wanted to sound like Premier, even people in LA. We didn't feel like that represented LA. And we were weird enough as it was, so we fell in between, one foot in the gangster rap thing or whatever, because we're in LA, and then but we're not going to be making, and we love New York hip hop, but we had to just make our own thing to make us happy. And so now we just keep that going, and fortunately, as these trends come and go, it doesn't really affect us. San Francisco Nights is still one of our biggest songs that we do every show, and we made that in 98 in, my parents' house and bedroom,
That's crazy.
Nothing's changed.
And people come to the show probably just to hear that song and get us on there. I guess he dug the song. He said he grew up listening to his, OST, Next Step, and all that. And, as hip hop, you like something, loop it up, rap over it. That's hip hop.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I guess he reached out to us. We did a show together in New York, and things went from there. We did a little small tour with him. Mm-hmm. Support,
Yes. I thought it was real unfortunate to see people who felt like they were our fans or they were supporting us trying to diss him for rapping over it, because the way we look at it, you know, this, here's a kid from another generation who's genuinely talented, whose heart is in the right place. That's the last person we would ever shit on. That's the last person we would ever try and sue for $10 million for rapping over a track.
Yeah.
You know, that's not a good look. You know what I mean?
It's hip-hop, man.
Yeah, this is hip. We scratch each other's lyrics. This is a community, and as far as I'm concerned, Mac is a part of that.
Hip-hop started with stealing other people's music. You know, so who are we, you know?
Yeah,
we still music.
Based our career, there's gonna be a lot of stolen music tonight on stage.
Yeah. What's the current music scene looking like right now back home in LA? Do you think there's any artists, anyone we should, you know, keep an eye out for?
Kendrick Lamar.
Check out the boy Kendrick Lamar, man. He has a really dope album out right now. Me and this guy, we don't check for new rappers. We make our music, listen to old, you know. If we're listening to new music, we're trying to bag on it, you know, poke fun at it. But Kendrick Lamar, man, he's got a dope album. Check it out. Compton.
And I just say that Dre, it's about time Dre did something.
Yeah, because get out the gym, dude.
Yeah, dude, stop lifting weights and taking, or supposedly taking ecstasy, or whatever the hell you do with your beach money, you know, making headphones in China, whatever it is. About time you put some music out, you know, because the West has been missing that. I think the nation has been missing that. It's been too long where there hasn't been a diverse set of hip-hop. It's been dudes from New York trying to sound like the South, dudes from the South trying to sound like the South.
Dudes from L.A. trying to sound like New York.
Right.
From L.A. trying to sound like the South, you know.
But as far as we can speak on L.A., and I think that voice was missing. And it's good to have it back, and I think it's good because aside from that, Kendrick's a good person to put out front. He's talented, the beats are good. It's a win-win situation, man. You know that the West is getting back on the map. I mean, I think it's reminding people.
On the wide scale of things, you know, in the mainstream, definitely. I mean, the dude did like 250 the first week. That's pretty damn good. I'm proud to say he's from L.A. I'm talking about L.A. stuff that we can relate to, you know.
Yeah, the dude sounds like little dudes that you see. I mean, he's way more than Odd Future ever was. I feel, at least, this is my opinion. I won't cast a sign on one, but I felt like everyone was quick to jump on Odd Future, but the stuff Kendrick's rapping about and the way that he approaches his lyrics and life, I think is more indicative of what a kid is going through right now who's going to high school in L.A.
Word.
You know, it's not all weird, you know, eating cockroaches and shit.
Nah, hell no, man. That's the most shock value.
Yeah, it's blog rap, you know, but Kendrick's rapping about streets that we travel on a daily basis and things that happen in L.A. And he's using slang that we're very familiar with, like homie.
You know,
it's real comfortable.
Can you tell us some of the LA slang? Like, I don't know, like what does homie mean? Like,
the homie, you know, that's my homie.
Oh, homie.
The homie, yeah.
Yeah.
You know?
But you got to twist it around.
Like, you do the homies, you know what I'm saying? Like, look at those homies over there, you know. And the homies can either be really good or really bad, you know what I mean? Depends what homies you're kicking with. I don't kick with those homies today because you know you're going to get in trouble, you know? So.
And then, like, if you get faded, you're like, that's the
yeah. Yeah, getting faded. You know, I don't know if you guys sat up here when you know, you're real lit on that faded. You know, that's the LA thing.
And then, like he said, I heard on the album today, I was listening to it, he said BG a lot, and that's something that, like, I think our albums are the only ones you ever heard that term. Well, you know, aside from other ones, but, you know, the term BG, and, you know, talking about Pyru and this and that, whatever, things that are real LA, you know?
Yeah.
Cruising and dominoes, like, you know. We play dominoes.
Right. Big time.
Yeah. It's not just for show.
Yeah, yeah. It's like real life stuff.
Dominologist, yeah.
That's good.
Yo, 1-2-1-2 in the place to be. It's your boy DJ Double K, and he is.
That's one, and we are.
The people under the stairs. Chillin' with Yeti in the basement. Can you do it?
Are you ready for this?